So, you guys know how I love a film reference, right? Welcome to the Italian job. What's up, guys? Welcome back to episode number 67 of Passport to Poland. And I made an Italian job reference. It won't be the last one I make this episode, believe me. Today we are going to Milan in the Champions League group stage. Since we last met, we have had a game against Jagiellonia that we lost 1-0, and then we defeated Lecce 5-2, absolute smashing. Harris Seferovic getting two, and Reece Devine getting himself a hat trick, which is just disgusting stuff. When your left back gets a hat trick, you know you've done a demolition job. Although that said, our league form not great at the moment. We are currently sitting eighth in the extra class, so we do have two games in hand. But even if we win those, that would still only put us up into somewhere around fourth, unless we did some absolute bits. So let's not get too excited because we've still got to chase down the title again. We've got to get ourselves back into title contention. There has been some transfers because the window closed just before the Poland game we did last episode. So let's just make sure we know what's going on transfer-wise. It was mostly a bunch of old guys came in. I was going to go through them all kind of individually. But we'll just go through the ones we'd like to see around. First, Stiglic has come back. He's not come back to play. So let's not get too excited. He has returned to the club, but he has returned to be a scout for us. He's not the best scout, but I saw he decided to become a scout, so I thought I'd pick him up for nostalgia's sake, although he'll probably play in the odd cup match here and there. Otherwise, guys like Kaminski and Rebus, they've come in because they have Polish caps. They're not awful for the first team. They're there really as cover because I can register them. It gives me a few extra players. Rebus is their left back. Like I said, they're just there to give me extra options to add more depth to the squad if I need it. Same with Maslowski. Who else has come in and started to play? Oliver Norwood came in. I brought him in originally because I thought, he'll turn into someone. He wants to be ahead of your development. I thought he'll be a nice guy to tutor people. He's got some good mentals, and it turns out he's actually good enough for the team still. So I thought, why not, make use of him? So we'll probably see him at some point. We brought in Jakob Johansson to be a sort of a mentor as well. I don't know if we'll see him. We might do. He's pretty good at the whole defensive midfield thing, so that's a possibility. A Swedish international, Shinji Kagawa, the former Manchester United player, he has come in again. It's his mentors we're looking to have imparted upon the team rather than him actually playing. He might get the odd cup game, but it's literally a tutoring job. Kidner and O'Neill are two young players, same with Garrido, Buisson and Murphy. Xu Long I brought in because I figured he's a Chinese international and that sells shirts. It's the only reason. I don't think he'll ever be good enough for the team. I want to see if we can sell some shirts and get our merch up. We'll probably turn a profit on him. Juan Mata has come in. Juan Mata, of course, the Juan Mata, the Chelsea and Man United Juan Mata, who apparently had a season with Norwich in this save, and then Vigo and Montpellier. He's here to teach. He might well play at some point, but he is here mostly to teach. And who can turn down Juan Mata? Lucas Vaca is again another defensive midfielder who is here purely for his mentors. All these guys, I've not, because I didn't need any players really. I didn't need any new signings for the purpose of improving the team. There was no one available and we're good enough for what we need to do. So I also brought in guys like Tim Krul to help me train some goalkeepers. And also I brought in Daniel Subasic to help me teach some goalkeepers, those who aren't aware of him. He was at Monaco for a long time and he is currently at Mallorca, or was at Mallorca, I should say. So he's coming to help me teach. In terms of players going out, because obviously it was the end of the window, I sold, I think this is the only two you didn't see, Nilic. Nilic went for 1.6 million, which was a good deal because, he wasn't worth anywhere near a tenth of that. We got rid of Marcin Štětina. He is a Czech right winger, one of the guys I brought in actually to train up. We've sent him out to develop, so we'll see how he goes. And then we sold this guy, Damian Banaszak, who is a Polish defensive midfielder who came through our youth team. He wasn't going to make it, and then Legia came in and offered us like 82,000 for a player who, frankly, I was considering releasing anyway. So I took it. I don't know why they want him. I can't see why they need him, but apparently they do. So anyway, let's go do our thing where we play Milan, and I have that horrible sinking feeling I haven't sorted out the squad yet, which could be interesting because I took a couple of days off recording because I figured why not, but I've got a feeling I forgot to set the team up before I did. So this is the preview. They're the favourites because they're AC Milan. We're on better form though, which might work out, you never know. Nor would it matter, aren't registered for the Champions League because I didn't have an opportunity to, but Norwood for sure is registered for the league. I can't remember if I registered Matter or not. I have a feeling I didn't, but it's fine because he wasn't intended to be brought in to play. I definitely haven't sorted out the team. Give me 2 seconds in your time and I will come back with a fully sorted out team. And as if by magic, I've sorted out the team. So the team today is Sherpen, Cruz, Gomez, Guay, Devine, Rico, Longstaff, Gonzalez, Magoma, Wright and Seferovic because Sterling isn't quite fully fit yet. We're going to keep trying to get him to fitness. I'll try and get him on today though because he deserves to have a game at the San Siro. Makoviak, Belodi, Williams, Šimčak, Liss and Matic are on the bench. Šimčak I don't think we've seen on the channel before. He was the guy I brought in from Lech, the guy I spent 800,000 on. I'm pretty sure I showed you this guy before. But he's played a game for us and he had a really good game, so I was just trying to keep Wright match fit, so I put him in his place, and actually he did a good job. So we'll let him have opportunities. We'll see how he can develop. But yeah, in the meantime, he's on the bench. That is the bench we're going with. Let's see what we can achieve. I think if we can get a draw out of this, we've done pretty well. We are playing AC Milan though, so we will see what we can do. Let's see what their team looks like because it's bound to be just dirty at this point. I've got a feeling Milan have probably signed quite a few big players when I've not been paying attention. I don't know why I think that. It seems like a logical conclusion to draw. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. It's taking its time to get there, which is always a good sign. There we go. Right, let's look at this team. So hard to read black on red. Luka Jovic is up top. Luka Jovic, Serbian international, 46 caps signed from Lyon, having been at Real Madrid and Benfica and Eintracht Frankfurt. He's been around. So he's worth £62 million, which would buy our entire squad. This will be Christian Pulisic. No pressure, just Christian Pulisic. Who has 68 caps at this point, having been bought from Chelsea. This guy, Krzysztof Piątek. So they've got a Polish player. He's worth £49 million. So he shouldn't be a problem at all for us to take apart. God. Paqueta. This would be Lucas Paqueta. He's still there. He is an established international worth £86 million. This guy is Frank Gessi. Only worth 62 million. This is mad. We shouldn't be on a field with players of this value. It's just not okay. Sergio Pinto, a regen signed from Huracan, Argentine international worth 17 million. This guy is Dave Black, a Uruguayan international. I'm guessing he's Uruguayan and something because Dave Black does not sound terribly Uruguayan. He's Uruguayan American. That makes way more sense to me. He's only worth 3.8 million, so he's quite cheap. In fact, he's available for loan. Let's have a little scout of him. Just in case, we'll have a little scout of him. Because if he's available for loan, and it says 69, we'll have a little look at him. Because he could be a player we bring in on loan just to test him out. They've got this guy who is Franco Acerbi. 6 caps for Italy. Has played for, well, currently plays for Lazio in real life. Has then played for Barca and Milan. So again, no worries there. Nathan Aki. We know Nathan Aki. Chelsea, Bournemouth, moved on to Bayern, now plays for Milan, worth £50 million and wanted by someone no doubt big. Wanted by Real Madrid. That's not scary at all. Deo Hernandez, a French left back who plays for Real San Sebastian, has recently joined Milan in real life, apparently. only 29 million quid's worth of... You could literally buy our entire team for 29 million. And then, of course, Gianluigi Donnarumma is in goal. So that's going to be a thing. Good times. Good times. There's probably players on the bench who I should recognise as well. William Carvalho. Yes, there's some players there. All right. Let's get into the team talk, shall we? Let's see what we can do with that. Because, you know, we need a good team talk while we do the Italian job. Something like this.
We are about to do a job in Italy. It's a very difficult job. And the only way to get through it is we all work together as a team. And that means you do everything I say.
Into the game, then. I think that was the most passionate team talk I was capable of giving. We're on the ball straight away, which is a good sign. I have a feeling I left Gabriele Belotti on the bench and didn't even realise it. And Gabriele Belotti, of course, is a player we signed from Milan. That looks like Guay, it is. We signed Gabriele Belotti from Milan. In fact, three of our top players come from our rivals in the group, because we signed Belotti from Milan, we signed Akiari Wright from Bayern, and we signed Kjell Scherpen from Ajax. So, some homecomings happening here. I've got to make sure I bring on Belotti now so he can enjoy being back at the San Siro. But Felipe Cruz is on the ball. Matty Longstaff picks it up. Rico, what can he do? Ball forward, ball to back to Longstaff. Back to Rico, the ex-Barca player. Back to Magoma, Seferovic, Gonzalez. Options all over. Rico, we're actually keeping hold of the ball. I say that literally as we give it away, as always. And Kessie is running at us, and we need to get some defending going on here. Guay needs to get back. He hasn't, but Kjell Scherpen has held it. Kjell Scherpen with an excellent double save to keep us in the game, which is masterfully done. Although they have now got a corner, and this is distinctly squeaky bum times. Get rid of this, boys. Get rid of... Oh, he couldn't do it. Piatek, a traitor to his country, of course, by scoring against a Polish team. Disappointing. They won't let him come home anytime soon. But, you know, obviously he made his choice now. It's too late. And, well, can't help but feel that Felipe should have done slightly better with that. And now we're back on the ball. This could turn into an absolute demolition job. Guay to Gonzalez to Magoma. Ball forward. And we have found Devine on the overlap. Reece Devine, of course, after scoring three goals in the last game, probably wants more. Reece Devine needs to focus on his job of getting crosses in. And that was not the one. That was very much not a cross. Though Devine picks up the throw-in. What's he going to do? Just find any of our players. That would make me very happy. Gonzalez heads it back to Devine. Devine, again, can't get a cross in. Finally gets a ball over. Magoma can't pick it up. Rico on the way forward. Seferovic is never getting to that. Seferovic wasn't getting to it. And Akiari Wright didn't see it in time. And that didn't work out very well on any count for us. Which is terribly, terribly disappointing. But we shall make the best we can of it. We just need to kind of stay in the game. That's very much the plan at this point. Show some passion. Matty Longstaff immediately showing passion. Going for the Milan players' ankles. Why not? Showing passion, though, always a plan. Kessie picks it up. Let's try and defend this. We have. Rico has done defending. Seferovic picks it up. He needs to hold it up and set someone free now. Set anyone free. That's not setting someone free. That's giving the ball away. Let's not do this. I know it's Milan, guys, but we are the champions of Poland. Let's at least try and play like we're the champions of Poland. Piatek plays the ball to Paqueta, and we need to do some defensive work now. Defensive work like Reece Devine heading it to Pulisic is probably not what we're looking for. Let's get rid of this, boys. Let's do some defending. Close down. That's a free kick. I am, because it's just occurred to me, I'm going to make a small change out of possession. I'm going to drop this defensive line back while I think about it, because that feels like a better plan. Let's drop that line of engagement down too. Little changes, but if it keeps us in the game, all the better, as Akiari Wright doesn't pick up the ball. And now Piatek is going to head it down to Paqueta. Weird choice. Could have turned and run with it. Teo has picked up the ball. What can he do? Good crossfield ball to Kessie. And let's... Defending, boys. Defending. Face up. Get rid of this. Good work. Get rid of it. There we go. Let's keep moving the ball back up into their half. Black picks up the ball. Gonzalez, he's going to get himself booked for that, surely. He hasn't. The ref has been lenient, way too lenient for that, frankly, because he was definitely behind him. That was definitely a tackle from behind. Pulisic, ball forward to Kessie. They can play it back if they want, but it doesn't feel like the right move. Ball forward to Teo. Let's close him down. Close him down. Watch him. Shadow him. Almost did the job. Almost. So close to actually defending. Reece Devine with a header clear, and Gonzalez should have let that fall to his feet. I feel like we're panicking. This game's going to go on forever, but I feel like we're panicking, and that's not worked out at all. And Longstaff is just overzealous. Overzealous. He needs to calm down. Very much needs to calm down. It's not the one. Pulisic with a cross. Let's head this clear. Definitely some regrouping needs to happen here. I think I'm going to switch back to a cautious mentality. I think that's probably smart. Sherpen to Gomez. Igor Gomez has picked it up, and what can he do with it? He's got options around him. Finds Felipe Cruz, who is one of those options. Magoma. I've just realised what's happening here. It's because in the end of the last game, I put things on full match, didn't I? Because we wanted to see the as much of Valdemar Lis's Polish debut as possible. I was just thinking, we're having a lot of highlights. It looks like it was end-to-end stuff, but we're having a lot of pointless highlights. And I'm glad that occurred to me only about 5 minutes into the game. Nothing drama. That's perfectly normal. Right, let's do another shout. More shouting. Passion, boys. Passion. Let's see some passion. We can do this. Mark Guay is looking nervous, which I don't want. I don't want nerves at the San Siro. Or a frog in my throat, which is apparently appearing. Gonzalez has got himself a booking. It was a matter of time for one of our lads got themselves booked. Let's, creativity, maybe? Inspired, okay. Inspired is good. We've got a throw-in. Reece Devine. Let's get rid of it. Seferovic. To Devine. To Gonzalez. All the way through to Seferovic again. What can we do here? Ball across. Acerbi. Good times. But we've definitely given the ball away in a dangerous position. Now they can run at us, which we don't want, as Teo, the left-back, picks it up. We need to start really closing down. We've gone cautious. It's probably saved us from conceding again, but we probably need to do something to win the ball back and try and hit them on the counter. We've got a few quick players. We should be okay countering. We just have to actually pull it off. Pulisic to Black. Let's close Black down. Let's do this. We've forced him to making a weird cross. Teo has a shot. Sherpen gets down late, but he does manage to put it wide. And that is as good as we can possibly do, I think. I'd be happy if we kept this down to sort of 2-0 or 3-0, I'm not going to lie. I'd like it to stay respectable. A draw is the best we can do, I think. But otherwise, just keeping it respectable would be ideal. That's gone about as well as we could expect, I think, for a first half. I didn't have a clip for the halftime team talk because I didn't know, how it was going to go. So I didn't have one to edit in there. It's fine. Although they're back on the attack, and if they score a second, they're going to absolutely start pulling us apart. They will start pulling us apart. Do not make any mistake. They will start pulling us apart. And Piatek has scored. Second of the game. Passport withdrawn. No longer eligible for the national team. We're not a fan of him anymore. It's not the one. Our fans look devastated. I'm not sure what they expected, if I'm honest. I didn't come into this expecting a win. If I'm honest. I didn't come into this actually expecting a win. We're going to get creative, and hopefully creativity isn't involved giving the ball away this time. Gonzalez to Guay. Guay needs to find the ball out to Devine. He does. Ball forward here would be helpful. Devine to Magoma. Magoma, what can he do? Anything at all? Ball to Alex Rico. Rico needs to play it to someone competent. Igor Gomez is fairly competent. Ball forward. Is that going to hit Cruz? It has hit Cruz. Longstaff, ball through. Oh, Kieri Vrij. Oh, sometimes his finishing, it just deserts him when I least need it to desert him. I mean, he's got a finishing score of 12. It's not like he's a world-class finisher. But also, he scores a lot of goals. He shouldn't have a problem from there as often as he does. Oh, just things. Right, get rid. G- Get Rid. It's, letting Head It Over is as good as Get Rid, but it's not quite as good. Rhys Devine is having an absolute mare out there. I'm going to take him off. It is time to start ringing changes, and Rhys Devine is going to make way for Makoviak. I'm also going to take off Guay and send on Belodi. Hopefully they'll realise just how good a player he was and they'll be scared. I'm going to save the last sub because I need to make a choice which of the front three is the best person to withdraw. Knowing that I want to send on both Liss and Sterling, which is somewhat troublesome. I say somewhat troublesome, it's a lot troublesome. Creativity and get rid of whatever this is. I don't want to see a highlight. It's going to have to be Wright because Magoma has decided to show up. And if Wright's coming off, it probably... Yeah, we'll send on Sterling. I'm not taking any gambles, sending on a guy I've not tested in Europe. I want to see if there is a possibility we can get a goal at the San Siro, and I think it's probably going to be Keziah Sterling that pulls it off. Plus, he needs to play to get his match fitness back. That's just science. Although they're on the attack now with Black. Black finds Pulisic to Kessie. Kessie with a ball forward to Pinto, and Pinto is now on a run. What can he do? Can someone defend? Ball from distance, and he's not managed to do anything worthy of that run. And we need to definitely show more passion and try and get ourselves back into this game, because that's going to be vital to try and get... If we can get a goal here, it should inspire some confidence at least. Sterling. First game for a while. Cruz, what can he do? Ball back to Rico. Rico has all the time in the world, finds Longstaff. Magoma unleashes Felipe Cruz, who doesn't go on an immediate run, which is unusual for him. Ball across, and Black has picked it up way too easily. Rico will clear up, and he needs to start thinking about who he's going to release. Probably not going to release Belodi anytime soon. He shouldn't be going further than the halfway line. Although Longstaff to Makoviak. Makoviak, we haven't seen in a while. Into Seferovic. Seferovic pops it straight at Donnarumma. He should have done something significantly better with that opportunity. You don't get 20 opportunities a game against a team like Milan. You have to take them when you get them. And he has, make no mistake, absolutely failed to take that opportunity. He had the opportunity to make himself a bit of a hero. He hasn't done it. It's going to be a 2-0. And... yeah. At this stage, as we confirm a 2-0, and we're going to have a little... we appreciate their efforts, I suppose. You probably think, you regret making those Italian job references now, right? I don't, because some of you have forgotten that that film didn't necessarily have a happy ending.
Hang on a minute, lads. I've got a great idea.
So, after the excitement of the Italian job, we are back into domestic action against Korona for the second game, which is a league game. We are 9th, they are 16th, as you can see on screen. Thought this game would be interesting purely because, well, I'm playing it because it was the next game after Milan. We haven't got a Champions League game for about a week or 2 weeks after this. So, I thought we'd do this one. It's also interesting to me because a little lad who plays for them by the name of Premislav Bargel, who you might remember as having played for us several times, is a key player in their side. So I thought we'd go and see how he's doing by playing against him. Today's team is Sherpen, Cruz, Gomez, Guay, Define, Rico, Longstaff, Gonzalez, Liss, Freit, Seferovic, Makoviak, Belodi, Williams, Shimchak, Magoma, Matic, Sterling, Zima and Nate. Not starting Sterling again purely because he's not fit and I need to keep giving him some game time to get him there. So, you know, slowly catchy monkey. Let's get into it. Let's see what we can do. Let's try and get ourselves at least one win this episode. I mean, the 2-0 loss to Milan wasn't the worst. It was fairly creditable considering we were playing in Milan and they should be destroying us. So it gives me a little bit of hope that we're on the right path developing the team. We can see Bargel there playing in central midfield. He's only got 6.75 rating for them thus far this season. There's no one else in that team, I don't think, who has played for us. Although I think we've done quite a bit of business with them over the years. I know Morgan Boyes is still there, but he doesn't seem to be playing. But yeah, this is the lineups. Let's get into it. Let's just go straight. And now we know that I've turned off the full match highlights. Now we can get into the game and try and get through it in a respectable frame of time. Yeah, be nice to pick up a win here. We need one. We need one quite badly. Not least because although we've got two games in hand, we just need to start playing some catch up. Sixth is the highest we could go in the league by winning those games in hand right now, which is slightly disconcerting, I think. It's not the ideal, but we'll see how it goes. And one of our games is against Vistula Plock, so we'll see how that goes. That will help us up the league, hopefully. But we're not doing great so far. We are, in fact, doing almost nothing so far. I'd have expected a goal by now, I'm not gonna lie. Maybe there's a bit of a Champions League hangover, maybe. Let's do some attacking, see if that does anything to help us out. We've not hit the ground running. The list for Magoma swap, of course, made because we have to have a certain number of under 22 Polish players in the team for the league. But so far, not going well. Everyone seems motivated by that, which is certainly beneficial. More creativity, shouting. Liss and Longstaff both not having great games, it's got to be said. But there's not a lot I can do about that because, you know, well, I mean, I can take them off. That's not the biggest drama. I can take them off. It's just a case of I'd rather not have to. And Longstaff has absolutely fluffed his lines there. Should have brought that ball down and got rid of it. And now he's chasing back, trying to get himself the ball. That's a penalty, surely. Surely that's a penalty. What a poor place to give away a penalty. I don't know why we're going to VAR for that. I could see that was a penalty. You could see that was a penalty. The ref surely saw that was a penalty. This has not gone well. If Bargel takes this penalty and scores it, I'm going to be really annoyed that I sold him to him. He is too good a player for Korona, too. Far too good a player. Wasn't good enough for us, but he is too good for Korona. It's an awkward situation. Let's see what we're going to do here. He has awarded the penalty, of course he has. And now Kjell Sherpen has a chance to make himself a hero. But will he do it? Will he make himself the hero we need? We're going to take Longstaff off either way, I think. It's gone wide. Oh, he hit the post and it went wide. That's poor. Hopefully that won't affect Longstaff's performance too much, but I've got a feeling it will. Let's more creativity, please, guys. Let's do something. It's going to be time to make changes. Unless we score here. Gomez, ball forward to Longstaff. Longstaff needs to redeem himself now. Gomez forward to Cruz, to Longstaff. Longstaff with a through ball here could create something. To Liss. Valdemar Liss is in. Valdemar Liss hits the post. Oh, unlucky. Unlucky. And we have got ourselves a corner. And Liss is going to take it. And this will be a perfect time for him to contribute an assist. It goes into the box. Back post. Seferovic heads it over the crossbar. And, we're knocking on the door, but the door is not opening, is what's happening right now. We're going to take Matty Longstaff off. We'll send Paris Magoma in. I'm trying to think what my options are in terms of replacing Liss. I think Shimchak is the only option I've got on the bench, which is poor planning. I mean, I can move Seferovic back there, I suppose, if I need to. But let's not make that option number one. If we can avoid it, option number one would be that Liss suddenly comes into the game. It doesn't look like it's going to happen. Oh, he is starting to come into the game. Okay, we might be onto something here. We might be onto something. Let's do some changes. We'll take Seferovic off. We'll put Keziah Sterling on. We need a guy who knows how to score goals. And we'll take Felipe Cruz off for some fresh legs in Nico Williams. I know Felipe Cruz is the best player on the pitch for us, but you know, we need that pace. We need something to create opportunities. Let's go very attacking. Why not? I know it never scores goals, but we've got no other options. We just need to start running at them now. Just need to start running at them. Come on, anything. A 0-0 draw is not how I wanted this episode to end. I was hoping we'd do a demolition job, if I'm honest. To borrow a phrase, blow the bloody doors off. But we didn't achieve that, and the final whistle is gone. It's a 0-0 draw, and we could be in real trouble in the league right now. We're having the same problem we did with the first Champions League campaign, where our players seem to get hyped up for Champions League football and can't bring themselves back around in the league to make it work, and it's quite frustrating. It's really frustrating when that happens. I'm not sure what I can do to help the situation, which makes it worse. But there we go. That's another story for another time. We're going to see what happens with the press conference. I suspect nothing magical. Are we concerned by his poor form? No, because he wouldn't be playing if he was like that. Raheem Charles, nope, because it's worked this far. I don't know. Right, let's wrap up the episode, guys, before we end up into a 1,000-hour-long episode, because otherwise things will go crazy. Thank you for watching, guys. As always, it's been a pleasure having you here. The socials are down there, so hit up them socials. Like and subscribe for more FM content. I'm going to try and ramp it up over the next few weeks and add some more, as well as start doing some football stories, because everyone loves a good football story. Aside from that, though, guys, as always, I've been Chasing Lamely. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, have a good one.